teachers know when to apply the cane and when to refrain, when to, you know, just give you a scolding and when to tell you to go to your room. I think he had all it took, you know, to be a strong leader, and he was, you know. But because he was very democratic, first of all, believed in the tenets of democracy, you know, and because, again, like you said, he was modest, and not just modest, he was also a very humble person. You know, in later years, I even came to hear more stories about my father from people, you know, I had never met when he was alive, who had had different interactions with him. And the one thing, if there's one trend, apart from his modesty, was his humility, you know. And oftentimes people will mistake that for weakness, but he was not necessarily weak. I don't think he was at all. On the contrary, I think he was, you know, a strong character.
And when people wanted him to be vengeful, for example, there was the group that wanted Rawlings to be caged again. I mean, try the guy, arrest him, remove the transitional provisions, do this. Liman was bombarded left and right, but he stayed on course and said, my ideology is gone. It didn't mean that he didn't understand the socialist order. He wanted some more socialist social interventions, just like the CPP would do. And it was being directed, no two ways about it. The party was very powerful.
But if you ask those who were there, and indeed for those who met President Liman, the question he kept asking them was, should he have just taken and started shooting people to kill them? Is that what people expected him to do, as Jerry Rawlings did? He shot people and killed them. He killed former presidents. And at the end of the day, what happened? Did we succeed as a nation because we killed people? Or upon rumor that somebody is staging a coup or want to topple you, do you just go and arrest the person? Is that the rule of law? Liman wanted that anytime anybody was talking about a coup, you should be able to provide sufficient information so that the security agencies can take it up.
In Africa, tough leaders are leaders who kill. Strong leaders are leaders who kill. We have examples all over the continent. I won't mention specifics. But Dr. Liman said, strong leaders lead strong institutions. So his desire was to build strong institutions, the judiciary, the military, parliament, the executive. These are the institutions that need to be strong so that the nation will sail.
It took less than 6 months for President Dr. Liman to be able to ensure that, look, we have sufficient food supplies, we have sufficient provision supplies in almost all our shops, so that people can now walk freely and go and pick, and not that you now have to depend on something. It takes a strong character. It takes a determined and a focused leader to be able to do that. Of course, if you did not have fuel to run in your economy, fuel is not just for driving cars on the street. Fuel is needed to ensure that agricultural productivity was on board. Fuel is needed for industry to power. It takes a strong character to be able to lobby, to be able to get these supplies into the country, particularly when at the time we were not producing any of that. So that is the mark of a strong leader and not of a weak leader.